But tell us about, you know, you've got this passion, this fiery passion for acting. Tell me, how did it all begin for you?
Well, I'd always fancied it, you know what I mean? But I'd never got fully involved in it.
Yeah.
And really, I was humming and hawing with going to some sort of classes.
Yes.
And my nephew came back from school. He was going to be in a school play. And he said all the lads were laughing at him.
Yeah.
And I said to him, look, you just go and do your thing, what you want to go and do. And he went back and he got in the play and he did a great job. And I thought to myself, well, if I'm telling him to do that, why don't you man up and go and break down another barrier, do you know? And I joined that Act Up North then, and I went going there. That's where I first met you, the first day, remember?
Well, it is good, like, Act Up North. I like here. They study, they concentrate a lot on, like, Stanislavski,
yeah,
method acting, objectives, giving circumstances, subject acting. Mm. Acting. It is very, very good. And, you know, I've just got great memories of Act Up North.
I thought it was great. Yeah, and I thought the people there were great as well.
You know,
you go 1 week, everyone's very open, aren't they? You know, you can be relaxed, no one's laughing at you or taking a mick. You'll focus on one topic of acting, and then they'll give you the script, and then you'll learn your script, and you'll come back next week and do it on camera, and everyone critiques it. And a different thing every week, and you just build up your confidence then, don't you?
Yeah.
I mean, before I used to go, because I was a bit older, I used to go for a coffee before, and half of me saying, just go home, you silly old sod, you know. You know, just go home, you know, what are you doing? And it take up all your confidence to get in there. And once you're in there, it was fantastic, wasn't it?
These people are good.
And you'd walk back and you'd feel so cathartic. Yeah. And you've had a great release and you've learned something. And then after a few weeks, it was like natural just to get go there, wasn't it? And see everyone. And
what I love about the arts is it's the social aspect of it all. That's why I'm always involved in it, trying to encourage people to get involved in the arts. Because it's the social aspect of it.
Yeah.
And I know with these drama groups, there's often, quite often, people start getting together and having little drinks parties afterwards and stuff like that.
That's what sort of happened to us with the drinks. But I prefer to keep the acting side separate from my social, if you like. But it's a whole social on its own.
Yeah.
I mean, from the Act Up North, just, I don't quite know how it happened, but someone in there, I was going to do a theatre play, which I know nothing about. So I said, I'm in town, and he's going for this audition. So I said, well, and he was a bit nervous, so I said, I'll meet you at the audition and, you know, help you out to do it. And so I went there, and he didn't turn up.
And you
So the director goes, well, you're here. It was a pirate thing. He said, do you want to read? I thought, well, I'll have a practice audition there. It won't cost me anything. And I went home and I got the role.
You got the part.
Yeah.
What was that in?
Pirates Rock.
Oh, that's it. Is that City
Theatre? Liverpool City
Theatre, yeah. Good crowd, them, aren't they?
Great. And, you know, to be involved in that, to see nothing, you know, 15 people coming together, all doing their bit and developing. It was a musical, so everyone's developing and getting better and tighter and tighter and tighter. And then to do the three shows was just fantastic, you know, and there's a bond created there. That's what I mean by the social aspect of it.
Yeah.
You know, you could do it without the ale or any other additives that you need to do. That in itself is good enough for me. And it's the whole ages and everything as well. Everyone shares that common passion, don't they?
Yeah.
Well, actually, if you go out in the group, you know, you're going out with young ones who are, you know, in the 20s and older ones who are maybe in the 60s and you know, you're in the middle there, and that's a hard dynamic, yeah, isn't it, if 20 of you go out.
I think what it is, another magical thing about it is, like, I remember somebody saying, why are actors always lovey-dovey and all that? But do you know what I think it actually is? Because you get together and you become developers like a family, and to heading towards this, you rehearse and doing your prep, rehearse, and then you do the show. And you live or die together.
You do.
It's the fact that you live or die together.
You know what it's like? It's like, I was a professional rugby player, you know, in my youth.
Oh, nice.
And when I finished playing, when I was 39, I think, there's been a big hole in my, you know, a big hole. Yeah. And it's theatre is a similar thing to a rugby team. You know, you go and do all your training, you have your position, but you have to work with everybody else. And then you have your match, don't you, where you all come together. And just funny enough, last night, there's like a show on Wednesday nights every month in Liverpool called Indie Flicks. And they show like five short independent films.
Oh, right, yeah.
Yeah, down in the vines it is. And I was outside chatting with this fella, and he was a boxer, you know. And I said, how are you doing down here? He said, all right, yeah. I said, you do a bit of acting? He said, yeah. I started acting up north, he said, about 4 years ago. He said, after I finished the boxing, he said, I had nothing to do with it, you know. I was empty and I started the acting. He says, now I'm on the telly and doing all sorts, he said. And that's what I'm saying, you know. It's a real release for people and a focus
It's the release and the focus.
And the passion you get when you start doing it. It's fantastic.
I know with City Theatre, I know that you had the success with the Pirates.
Yeah.
I went to see you in a play. I think it was City
Theatre. Warnock.
Well, you were very good in that. Yeah,
the prison one.
Was your character in that? Tell us about that play.
Norris Anderson. It was Barry had written it. Barry Levy had written it. Peter Sebastian directed it. It was fantastic, guys. It was a youth female detention centre. So it was an adult themed play. It was quite gritty. It was dealing with issues of rape and abuse in the prison itself. And I was the sort of like relief coming on. You know, like an older fella who's retired and tries to help people out on gardening duties. I'd take them out on gardening duties, you know, and they'd all take the mickey out of me, and I'd be a nice big soft fella. Norris Anderson, his name was in the play.
That was your character, Norris.
Yeah, Mr. Nobbit.
Mr. Nobbit, that's good, Ed, I remember. Yeah. Tell us about your prep for that.
Well, I'd gone away, really. I mean, when you do the theatre, I think it's really important that you go to all the rehearsals. And Barry had written up this character in mind for me, and I said, I was going away for a month, you know. But it was the first month of 3 months rehearsals. So I took the script with me and was learning it while I was away, so I wasn't breaking in. I said, are you sure about that? He said, fine, yeah. So he said, I wanted to be someone like Norris from Coronation Street.
Yes.
Yeah, the fellow with the glasses, yeah. Is it Norris?
Not McWhirter, was it? Yeah.
Not McWhirter. Yes. Norris, the bald fellow with the glasses.
Yeah, I remember him, yeah.
He works in the shop, you know. Yeah. And I thought, well, I can't be him, exactly him, can I? But it's given me a link. And some sort of Lancashire accent came out to me. I'll tell you what it was. That's my eyesight. I was reading the script.
Yes.
And I thought it said black. It started off on the beach, two people on the beach, two vagrants on the beach. And in black underneath the thing, it said Blackpool. Well, it didn't. It said Blackout. So I dreamt it as Blackpool.
Blackout at the end of the scene.
Yeah, the end of the scene. Well, I dreamt it as Blackpool,
yeah,
you see.
Oh, God,
you
don't
get it. And I thought, well, I'll get a Yorkshire accent on for it. A Lancashire accent on for it.
It worked, didn't it?
So when I arrived, he said, that works really well. He said, where did you get the Lancashire accent? And I said, well, it says Blackpool in the script. He said, no, it doesn't. But it just sort of morphed in from working on that Norris, but making Norris me as well, putting myself in it. And this character just sort of morphed, you know, over that month because I was away. And I was learning the script, and it was just sort of sitting through in bed on this character, some sort of jolly sort of fella, you know.
But that's the great thing about it. There's a story behind the development of every character.
There is, yeah.
Obviously, in the script, it said Blackout, and you thought it said Blackpool, and you developed your character
as a
Blackpool.
As a Lancastrian sort of do-gooder.
City Theatre is very good though, isn't it? No, Colin Jones.
Colin Jones, yeah, great.
He's a good lad.
Very disciplined.
Colin Jones, just dedicated.
Always plays a cracking baddie, you know.
He's played a baddie, yeah. He's always a good mate, Colin.
Yeah, he's
good
a great lad.
Yeah. So what else are you doing? Are you still at City Theatre? You've got something else going
on? I'm still at City Theatre. There's a play. We did. Well, if we go through the plays, we did Pirates Rock, and then we did the Warnock, and then. I got pulled into another play then, Verdict, Agatha Christie.
Oh,
right. So we did two at the Castle, and one over in West Kirby, and one up in Wigan, and then, which was a different ball game altogether, because you learn, you know, it's...
Was that with a different production?
Yeah, Sherry Jones, yeah, Woollywood it was, Woollywood Productions. Very different set of actors, more mature, very different feeling on, you know, in rehearsals and stuff like that, very serious. And then I finished that and we did Pirate Rock 2 again. And now they're doing another one called, based, it's an adult comedy based on Robin Hood.
Yeah.
And God knows what the name is. I'm not in it because I'm going away.
Oh,
I'm going to be away for 6 weeks, so that
yeah,
it's not fair to go and, you know, mess with rehearsals for people.
You can't commit, commit yourself to that.
But there's one after then, a pantomime based on Jack and the Beanstalk for Christmas. So they're bringing me as the Giants.
Oh, you're
so
they penciled in. Oh, that's good, yeah. And where's these going to be performed? Is it,
they're all in Hope Street Theatre. The old Masonic Lodge there.
Yeah, the Hope Street Theatre, yeah.
Yeah, about 18 months ago, they started a bar there called the Arts Bar.
Yeah.
And they've developed studios, and it's cracking, and it just gets better and better. And it's a real hub in Liverpool for actors and artists now.
Yeah.
You know, you go down there, and every sort of up-and-coming or young creative is in there.
Yeah,
it's in like a mixing, having a drink. I hope, yeah, is the word. Yeah, it's a fantastic place.
I know it's got brilliant rehearsal space, hasn't
it? Superb, yeah, and they get better. So you can see that they're putting them. You know, when you first went, it was just an out of room.
Yeah.
And now, you know, they put the rubber floors in and mirrors and stuff like that. It just gets a bit better and better. So the money that they're making, they're putting back into to make it a better space.
I know they have live acts on there in the bar as well, don't they? Live.
They have open mic nights, yeah.
Yeah.
All different sorts of things going on. I don't get involved in that, though.
Yeah.
The other rehearsal space in town's Caledonia.
Oh, that's the Caledonia. Upstairs.
Upstairs, yeah. With the chippy, greasy floor. But it's a free space, isn't it?
Yeah,
so it's worth remembering.
It's absolutely fantastic.
And that's a cracking boozer as well, isn't it?
Well, they have all the top live acts in there.
Yeah.
I went with my mate John Pagosa to the Caledonia. And funny enough, we met years ago. A heightened ukulele club, and we went to the Caledonian, and someone said, "The guy who's going to be playing the ukulele tonight, a banjolele, is reputed to be the best in the country." And we thought, "Oh yeah, you know." And anyway, this I can't remember the name of the ukulele player. It was in the Caledonian, and once we heard them after about 15 seconds, we both looked at each other and said, "Should we throw our ukuleles in the bin?" That's the standard.
It's such a crazy pub, isn't it? You get standard, all different types of bohemian people in
the
there.
The standard's superb, yeah. I went to see a live play in there. A play performed actually in the pub.
Oh, right.
Scott the writer was, I can't remember his name, but it was a live play about a pub, and it was performed in the pub in the Caledonia.
Yeah.
It was fantastic. But that's it about Liverpool. It's all acting, music, poetry. Hope Street is actually, and around that area.
It's amazing, you know, it really is amazing. And that, the whole area in itself, you know, if you think from when it was established to its whole history, to what it's all gone through, to where it is now.
Yeah.
It's just one of those places that's a survivor, and you can feel it in the streets, can't you? You can feel
the vibe.
Yeah, you can feel that buzz. Yeah. You know, there's a real.
The
cathedral's there as well, you know, and everything like that.
It's actually a brilliant. When I do my still photography, I've done quite a lot of headshots on Hope Street because it actually makes a brilliant backdrop for actors, and it's like sort of take industrial photographs. In a sense, where you're taking a picture of the actor and you've got like the blade, everyman in the background, or the Philharmonic. Hope Street is like you say, it's a hub.
It's amazing,
fantastic, you know. So what's your plans then for the future? You having a little break?
No, I've got, I've just been involved in a couple of little films.
Yeah, well, tell us about your film side of things.
Oh, the film side, well that started with, I'd been going to Act Up North and I thought, I feel confident now.
Yeah, it's good, yeah.
To go and do something. So I joined Star now. Still clueless about the actual film industry, really. Well, I knew a little bit about the acting for the telly, but...
Yeah.
So I've got this student film called Borders.
Wasn't Karen in that?
Karen was in it. She was a newsreader. Karen Souness.
She's a good friend. She's a brilliant actor.
So
she's great, Karen.
Marcus
And Marcus yeah.
Angelo, he was the lead in it, yeah.
Yeah, Sky, yeah.
So it was a great cast. Holly Hale, and a couple of others, can't remember the names. But,
what was that, Borders? What was telling
it was called Borders. It was like, it was a short, it was a student short about like a post-dystopic Brexit, really. Yeah. Where they were throwing all the foreigners out of the country.
Yeah.
And I was playing the boss in the office, but he's talking about learning on the job. The student roles were brilliant because everyone's fully committed. So we were in the small office, and you know, you've got two cameras on you, you've got the boom, you've got the script editor, you've got the two directors, and then it's just you, isn't it?
Yeah.
And I think I had to say something like, you know, open the door, actually leave it open.
Yeah.
So action, you know, it's like, just open the door, in fact, leave it open. Of course, it says actually on the script, you said in fact. Yeah. So I've gone, all right, yeah. Well, we'll change it to in fact if you want to say that. Right, take two. So then I've said actually instead of in fact. And I'm going, oh, come on. And you're getting a bit pressured then, aren't you?
Well, course,
so you take a deep breath and you go, right, come on, let's get on with this again. Anyway, we took about 8 takes.
Yeah.
We got it done. But yeah, it was your first one.
Yeah.
And then I think the script editor said, you talk about the nice people in acting. She went, I had a long scene to do next. Yeah. And she goes, bloody hell, this one's going to take a while, isn't it?
So,
I thought to myself, right, you know, Nick, and we did it in 2 takes.
Oh, brilliant.
So just learning something like that in a pressurised environment was great, really.
Yeah, put it in the moment.
Yeah, and you just get more and more used to it, don't you? I think after that we did some filming for Act Up North. Then I did some extra stuff.
Paul, tell me about that.
Yeah, a couple of real greats at the moment, young Liverpool directors, I think, Jay Cunningham Jones.
Yes.
I just went on set there, I sat in the cafe. That's like a Terminator, Android going wild, you know. It's taken him years, and he'll be out soon, I think.
Mm-hmm.
But just to see his mindfulness was fantastic, you know.
I'll have to tag with that film.
It's called Jones, J1S.
Like, well, it's something people can look out for then.
Really, yeah.
It's Made in Liverpool.
Made in Liverpool. There's another APG films, Andrew Games.
Mm-hmm.
You'd love this one. He's done a stylized sort of Western about the Teddy Boys and the Teddy Boy culture.
Oh, I see.
You know, the trailers look fantastic.
Yeah.
Again, just extras in that.
Yeah.
But I thought, I'll get in and have a look what's going on. And you learn by watching the actors.
Of course.
You see how much it takes.
Yeah.
And just to be on the set, you pick up a lot.
That's what people don't understand.
Yeah.
People don't understand the prep.
When you're doing, you know, you're watching, you're doing 10 takes on one camera, 10 takes on the other, 10 from the side, all the same thing, all at the same time. And when you're a bit tired, that's hard. It's quite hard work, really.
The big thing is the continuity as well.
Yeah, the continuity. And another one we're in is a guy called Peter Sinsayer.
What's that?
He works at the Vines. He runs an acting workshop at the Vines in Liverpool, and he's
is that the big house on Lime Street?
Yes, by the Delphi. Yeah.
Yeah.
And he's doing he does lots of little things, but he's doing a Liverpool crime drama called Metropolis.
Oh, right.
It's got a lot of the ex-Brookside casting.
Yeah.
And he's using a lot of local actors in that as well.
Yeah.
I've seen the trailers for that. It's fantastic.
Yeah.
So there's three. Local Liverpool filmmakers.
Yeah, it's all happening then, yeah, it's good.
You know, to keep an eye out for these films.
Yeah.
What else happened after that? I did a few more student films.
Yeah.
And then Channel 5 rang us up, Alaska TV rang us up.
Oh, tell me about that, yeah.
Yeah, I was, I'd only just started. It was only, so I did that first film in January.
Yeah.
And then I did a couple of the extra stuff. And then I was rehearsing at the theatre play, and it was a Sunday, and I was sitting in Sunday night, 8:30, and my phone goes on a unrecognised number. So I thought, you know, who's this? They said, such and such from Alaska TV, and
yeah.
We want to book you for Young, Dumb, Banged Up in the Sun. So
did you think, yeah, go on,
yeah, go on.
You think it's one of your mates?
I thought it was the lads ringing me up, so I nearly told them where to go. And I just thought, well, I'll just play, I'll just pretend that, you know, yeah. You're taking it on, and I'm going, yeah, 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 book me in for this. And all it turned out, all the gear came through, and off to Norwich I went, so I was in series 2 and 3. And I thought, not trying to blow my own steam or anything, because it sounds like that, but I think to be to have been on that in less than a year.
It's self-belief. You
know, yeah, I think it's just the confidence of going. So now, really, at this stage, I've done 9 films, really.
That's brilliant, that's deep.
4 plays.
Yeah, that's fantastic.
The TV stuff.
Yeah.
And 2 music videos. And the people that you meet, particularly on the Liverpool circuit, you bump into them all the time, you become really good friends, you know.
Oh, that's superb, that. Yeah. God, it's
weird, know. It's weird how it's gone, but, you know, I've committed to it.
You are very committed, there's no doubt about it.
Yeah, I mean, I take everything on that comes my way, I think.
Yeah.
You know, no matter what it is, I think, because you can only get better, can't you?
Yeah.
And it's good to work in all these different scenarios. Like, last week I did a Batman.
What was that?
For YouTube. It's a fan film for YouTube. Well, we filmed it last year, actually. And one of the guys ran off with all the film stuff, all the photography, do you call it?
Yeah.
So we said, let's do it again.
Yeah.
But again, so that'll get a lot of hits because, you know, on Comic-Con and things like that, people really love Batman. So it's a very low-budget film. But it's set in Liverpool, and we decided to use a lot of the sites of Liverpool. So, for example, the other day we were filming on the outside of St. George's Hall. Then we went over to Woodside Ferry so we could get the Three Graces in, and the warship was in. So we did a scene there. Then we went, because it's sort of Batman, then we went to the old tunnel entrance in Wallasey.
Oh, right.
And filmed outside there.
The back cave, yeah.
Yeah, so we were going into that back cave and it's all got disused signs over it, so it was ideal. And then when we come out of the cave, we were going to a posh house. So we were going to go to Croxteth Hall. And then I said, well, let's go to William Art Gallery in Birkenhead, seeing as we're near here. So we filmed that as well, so we did 4 different locations. So what I was getting out of that was trying to get the continuity of different scenes, but in different locations in the day. So you're learning again, aren't you?
It's a challenge.
And you've got to keep the same character on.
Yeah, well, you're coming on though, aren't you? It's fantastic.
You're just learning on it. And next week I've got a student play called Call Me Elvis.
Yeah.
So what that's about is a washed up Elvis impersonator whose life reflects what Elvis' life was like.
What's that called?
It's called Call Me Elvis. So I'm playing Tom, which is his manager.
And is he you're like the Colonel Tom Parker?
I'm like the Colonel Tom Parker, but I'm a landlord in a pub who runs, celebrity impersonator.
You want to keep us informed about all this?
I will do, yeah. So we're filming that the next couple of weeks.
Yeah, so what we're going to do with this interview, we're going to call this part one. Yeah, and you promised me we'll have to kind of wind up now because the batteries are going to start running out.
No, it's been great talking to you. Well,
it's been an absolute pleasure, Steve. Yeah. And, you know, it's just a pleasure. But you will come back after your holidays.
I will do.
And tell us.
And I'll let you know. And also, Tony, I want to thank you. I'm not even going to look at the camera, but I should do it here. Tony did all my headshots for nothing the first day I saw him, and I always keep them, you know. And no matter what happens down the line, I'll always have that one.
Thank you.
The one that look a bit like Barney Rubble. It's a great shot, though.
I just love photography. I like this side of the camera these days, Steve. But we'll wrap it up.
But I really appreciate that, you know, you doing that. It was marvellous.
Well, I'm always happy to do people's headshots, you know. I'll always do them. And I'm always looking at scripts. I'm hoping to do a short film soon as well. Mm. So I'm keeping busy, but I'm on this side of the camera these days. Yeah. So we'll wrap it up there, Steve. Have a great holiday and promise you'll come back for part 2.
I will do. Thanks, Tony.
Thank you, Steve. Thank you.